Hey everyone, and welcome to IJustWatched, and we're back, and we're here to discuss episode 5 of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Things are getting crazy. This episode was an hour long, and we get to see a lot. And one of my favorite things was, I gotta hit you with that reminder, is to hit that like button if you like this video. Click the subscribe to stay tuned to see more of our shenanigans, and hit the little bell to get notified when those get released. That being said, let's talk episode 5, the penultimate to the finale. Let's discuss. All right, so right off the bat, I'm not going to go in proper order. I'm going to go with the things that I remember the most, even though this is the beginning. I loved it when they whooped his ass. Like, it was a cool fight scene.
Hey, just like when they whooped his ass. Hey, yeah, like, hey. Just he was up here, knocked him down a peg. Just...
Yeah, hey, no. Hey, even with the super soldier syndrome.
The syndrome?
Yeah.
Bro, hey.
Even with the super soldier serum, you still got your butt cheeks clapped by Bucky and Sam, and it was cool just to see the setup. I like how Bucky, like, afterwards threw the shield at Sam, like, "Don't you ever let go of this again, sir," and then walked out. I'm like, "Wait, I'm hurt more than you."
And one thing is just like that Alan Walker, the whole entire time he was like fighting them, like,
you John get Walker to... Why you keep saying Alan Walker?
I don't know why. It's just
seems John Walker.
Agro Walker,
that's fine. That one works.
I apologize to Alan Walker. Once again,
for real.
He's like, "Man, put it through my name on like that." Yeah, disrespectful. Yeah. Ew. Nah, John Walker. Every time, like, we get to see him interact with people, he always introduces, like, "I'm Captain America. I'm Captain America." Or, "I'm fucking America." Like, yeah. "Hey, hold on. Hey, when the real Captain America, every time, what he say? He said, "I'm Steve Rogers."
Yeah.
I'm Steve Rogers.
Shunned. He got other than honorable discharge and all that shit. Like, part of me was like, "Oh, that sucks." Because it's like, yes, it's your fault, but it's also the fault of the government for putting you in this situation without you actually being cleared for it. Because clearly you have PTSD and all kinds of mental issues.
Yeah, problems that you should have been addressed.
So you should have never been in that situation.
Exactly.
But once they put you in there, those were your decisions.
Yeah, so part, like, you know, that's why, like, partly, like, a part of me was just like, okay, like, it sucks. It really does. Like, because I understand. And it's not really entirely your fault.
Yeah.
It's also the government's fault for putting you, like you said, putting you in the situation.
You should have never been in there.
You should never been in. And I mean, one thing led to another, and now here you are.
Yeah, and now, U.S. agent.
U.S.
agent. Now
you will become U.S. agent. And then, right after that, right after his, well, it's not really a court-martial, but right after his hearing,
yeah,
you know, we get to see Madame Contessa.
Yeah, okay, Madame Hydra, introduce herself.
Exactly.
Val, you know, as she says.
What's the actress' name?
Oh, I don't know it by heart.
I know Dreyfus.
I immediately
recognize. I just know the last name is Dreyfus. That's okay. All I know.
Like, I immediately
Dreyfus,
recognize
her. I can't remember.
Yeah.
But, like, yeah, she's Madame Hydra, so basically they got a big-time actress to play her, so that means we're going to see more of her.
For sure.
For sure.
Which is interesting, because she's talking about how the shield was never theirs, like, it never belonged to her, or how she, like, she's kind of basically doing, like, a reverse Nick Fury, which makes sense, because she's like, "I'm putting together a team," kind of situation. You can kind of feel it. Yes, that character plays Madame Hydra, but is she actually going to be Madame Hydra, or is she going to be Val, who is head of Leviathan, or maybe Val works with or in unison with the Power Broker? Like, there's a lot of...
Some people were actually stating that she might work with General Ross.
I could see that.
The Thunderbolts already.
I could see that.
Thunderbolts program.
Especially with Zemo being sent to the Raft.
Also, because we know General Ross was also trying to create the Super Soldier Serum from the Hulk movie.
From way back then.
Exactly. So, with that being said, you know, obviously, big character introduced.
Yeah.
And
more to come, for sure.
I mean, that just, you know, puts the stage up more for more shit to come.
And like I said, so Zemo gets turned over to the Wakandans, and the Wakandans take his ass to the Raft, and then the Raft gets dropped again. And if I remember correctly, Zemo is, like, kind of, like, originally involved with the Thunderbolts.
He's the head of Thunderbolts, actually.
Right? He's the leader?
He's the Deadshot of the Thunderbolts.
Yeah.
Which is funny, let's be honest, because the Thunderbolts is obviously this is a knockoff of Suicide Squad.
Without a doubt.
It really is. Once again, Marvel taking it from DC.
I like that idea. I
just change the name and put in my characters.
But I mean, like, so it's interesting because I think it's without a doubt we're eventually getting a Thunderbolts movie or show, because obviously we're going to get more of Zemo. We're going to get more
because one thing you said was that Baron Zemo looks like he's going to turn into Loki. Not like the character Loki,
but in a sense that reoccurring villain who's like
kind of a
lovable
good guy.
Yeah, like he plays on both lines. Mm-hmm. Like Loki did. Loki was kind of good and bad, whatever suited him most. Mm-hmm. And we literally saw it here. Zemo. We saw Zemo be a monster, and then here we saw Zemo kind of play both sides. So I feel like we'll see more of his character repeat that.
Exactly.
So he'll be the new Loki character. It comes to
exactly
playing both sides, basically. Whatever suits him.
I mean, also Daniel Bruhl just killing it. So, I mean,
yeah. Yeah, that's he knocked that shit out. This episode's great, but this episode is all set up because we see Carly go way off the deep end because she's working with Batroc. And then on top of that, you find out that
Sharon Carter
hired him again because apparently she hired him in the beginning.
Exactly.
So I hope she's not the power broker just because, like, even if the power broker's a female, I want the jaw and I want the superpowers. Like, you know what I mean? I don't want the mech suit yet. I would just like to see, you know, the metal jaw and, like, the full power. Not this Agent Carter who's kind of, like, good and bad. Like, none of that. I want full villain power broker. Exactly. I think she is, like, right hand of the power broker at the moment.
She has She has to be, like, some way up there for the power broker.
To be calling shots like that, mm-hmm. she has to be, like, the right hand.
But, like, being the power... Like, because, like I said, I have no problem with her being the power broker other than the fact that it has to be comic accurate, you know?
Give me the jaw.
And commit to the full villainy because I don't want no tippy-toe between, we're coming a good guy, coming a bad guy. Nah, we got that. We got Zemo for that.
Yeah, exactly. We've had that. We've got a new replacement already. Give me... Just go full villain. And it would make sense because, you know, she was the way she wasn't pardoned for all the stuff she helped Cap and all them with, so that she went full bad guy, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But, like, I'd like to see more. I wonder, you know, I'd assume we're going to get those answers in the next episode. Because the next episode, the finale, episode 6, has to be an hour and a half minimum on the reel.
Yeah, because this one was an hour already. Yeah.
It still was, like, tight because there were so many, like, we get a couple new characters. We get to see an idea of what might happen with other characters. But then you get the biggest thing is the implementation of the finale, which is the big parts is obviously Sam gets the shield and we get a dope montage of him training with it. Bucky calls in a favor with the Wakandans and gets him a suit, and I'm willing to bet it's his Captain America Falcon suit with hopefully vibranium. If he gets a suit from Wakanda that has any pieces of metal on it, it's not vibranium, they gypped you and they clearly hate you and want you to die. Like, why?
Not to mention this, that the MCU has been using vibranium for so long.
That's the strongest thing they got right now.
Yeah, that's the strongest thing, because they can't really introduce adamantium yet.
Not yet.
So it's got to be vibranium, you know? Or at best, Antarctic vibranium.
Yeah, like, you know, that's all. There's the two options right now.
Like, Bucky finally realizes, like, we didn't realize what me and Steve were doing by giving you the shield, because it's like... Like
to us, we're like, you're just a person we saw fit.
Yeah, hey, we didn't see color.
Yeah, they're like, look, all we saw was another person who's good, well-hearted, and deserves, and we know could carry the mantle.
Exactly.
That's what we saw, we didn't take into society. That was our fault.
Exactly.
And then you get that sad-ass story from Isaiah
Bradley.
That, I was like, bruh, like, they
and you get to so and you get dirty. Him saying, like, you know, like, no respectable man, no respectable black man would ever, you know, take up the shield. But Sam's like, you know what? I'll be a respectable black man.
Yeah,
take the
Sam's like, look, I'm going to do it because no one else will and the world needs it. And we're like, yes, pick that shit up. Go to work with it. I'm excited to see him as Captain America, to be honest. I think the way he was training with the shield and his Captain America Falcon suit, the wings have to be vibranium. That means he's going to have a shield and wings that are vibranium. Mm. That's power, bro.
That's power. Because vibranium is not heavy. It's light.
Yeah.
It's a light metal that is very durable. Yeah. So that's why
he'd do with his wings, he'd be able to, like, slice through stuff. Like, he'd mm-hmm. be strong.
Hey, indestructible.
For real. I'm excited to see that. I'm excited to see, because we get the bonding moment, again, this is out of order, between him and Bucky when they're fixing the boat, and Bucky's flirting with his sister. He's like, hi, Sarah.
Yeah, we get to see how Bucky now, like, you know, he's basically becoming, like, more open to Sam. Because it never really clicked to me, but Sam was the best, Sam was the best choice for Bucky to talk to, because Sam deals with veterans.
Yeah.
He had dealt with veterans for so long. And one thing that I did see, that I do remember, is that Sam was talking to Steve, and he told Steve, it's like, it's your bed, isn't it?
Yeah.
He said, it's your bed, it's too soft. Yeah. It feels like a marshmallow, you're about to get swallowed up. And we see Bucky in the beginning of the show.
On the floor, on the ground.
And then when he's at Sam's, he's you know, on the bed. Yeah. I mean, not on the bed, but on the sofa.
Couch,
but still, it's something. It's still, now it's different. And he's like having, like, a good sleep.
He's progressing.
We can see Bucky now progress and become better and, you know, get over his guilt and stuff. So, you know, like, I hope we get to see more of them.
Yeah, for sure.
Together.
Like, I like them as a team. It's fun. Especially now that they're at the point where, like, they love hate each other
mm-hmm.
Versus just hate each other.
We have a friend who's a friend.
Yeah, exactly. And then everything's going well. And then we get our first end credit scene that we got for this whole show. And it's literally... John Walker making his own shield. My only thing, like, he was beating cold steel. That's gonna make it brittle. That shield's not gonna last, Bato. Like, you should have heated it up first. That, I get you strong, but that's not how metal works. But he's literally putting together his own.
His Dollar General.
Yeah, his Dollar General Captain America shield. Which I think is gonna be cool, because I think when he's done with that thing, is gonna be neat to see him, like, kind of utilize it, but it better get destroyed. Like he's pounding, like he was pounding on cold metal. That's all I need to say.
At the best, I think that's gonna happen to him is that he's gonna get locked up in the raft as well.
Yeah, I think so.
They're gonna use him as part of the Thunderbolts as well, U.S. agent. And then obviously we gotta get more villains. Somebody was saying that we probably might get Ghost as part of the Thunderbolts, but I'm like, nah.
Yeah, I mean, hit or miss, maybe.
Maybe. But one thing that we did forget to say is that Sam leaves his original wings.
With Torres. And in the comics, Torres, when Sam becomes Captain America, Torres becomes the new Falcon.
With the green suit.
But technically, he mutated. He actually has, like that's a weird storyline, but we can get a version where he just becomes a regular Falcon. So it's kind of, like, kind of sprinkling that in. So that's kind of a maybe. We might see him become the next Falcon. Exactly. I think it'd be cool just to be seeing, you know, give him kind of a sidekick. Because, I mean, they've been working together this whole time.
Exactly. So even though, like, technically, like, we don't really need a psychic because we have a partner.
That's 100% you have your partner. But it would be cool because then he can kind of do his own thing as Falcon. And then, hey, yo, Taurus, I need this information. Yes, sir.
Because honestly, it'd probably be like Falcon. It'd probably be like Taurus Falcon actually working for the military. And then Cap. Sam Cap. Just, yeah. Hey. I need your help on this.
Yeah. Give me this intel. Hey, you know the intel you're not supposed to give me?
Give it to me. And Taurus like, you got it, boss.
Hey, all right, here. I already had it ready.
No, you're going to ask for it already.
Yeah, I got you. It's in your computer at home.
You want a juice?
But I mean, we like the show. Like, this episode 5 was just this giant, like, lead up, the way it ends and everything. So now we know that episode 6 is going to have a huge, huge moment because you're going to have Carly and the Flag Smashers. Mm-hmm. You're going to have Batroc, who's trying to kill Falcon.
Which, by the way, she's in New York.
Yeah, they're about to. They took over. It literally ends with them taking over. As like a new Hydra with the One World, One People. I was exactly. Oh, shit, that's how Hydra shit.
That's about Hydra stuff.
During the whole GPD or whatever they're called, right?
I think that's Gotham City Police.
Hey, I love them, all right? I can't help it. You're right, that is Gotham.
GCPD?
Yeah, no, what is the GRC or some shit
GRC,
like that?
GRC, Global Reform...
Cunts. Cunts, yeah, that works. They take over that, but then you're going to have, obviously... like the Power Broker somehow is gonna either some kind of involvement or something like
that.
There's
no way that this show gets a second season.
No, I think if it gets a second season, it's gonna be a different title, as in the character's new title possibly, but it's gonna lead into something else. Like, it won't really... I think that we're gonna get a definite ending here, at least with the majority of these characters. Mm-hmm. But no, I mean, I'm excited to see where it goes. Season six. Wow. Episode 6 to end it off. Hopefully.
Damn.
Hopefully
six,
it's long.
Homie?
Yeah, bro. It's great. It's
fucking wild. A bet.
Thanos back twice.
I count me in. Always love Thanos. Should have won from the beginning.
I mean, technically, kind of did.
No. But you should just stay with
him. Oh, okay. No, that's not. No. Because our luck, we'd have got blipped.
So you won it, huh?
No, yes. But all in all, we want to hear your thoughts. What do you think of the show so far? Are you excited for future Marvel shows coming out, future Marvel movies coming out? And what are your thoughts on how this ends and where it goes with these characters? Down below in the comment section, let us know. We love hearing from you. But until next time, whatever.
This is our post-credit scene.
Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. Yeah.
That's because it just came up to me. But apparently, I think Madame Hydra was supposed to make her first debut in Black Widow.
Yeah, I read that too.
Yeah, and then so
clearly Black Widow got pushed back. So that means we'll get more from her in Black Widow, which possibly means that Taskmaster works for the Power Broker or Madame Hydra or whatever organization.
Whatever organization is part of that. Yeah, right now.
Like Leviathan, like whatever they're tied to, which would be interesting because I want to see what her role plays there. You know what I mean? So now, but especially because this was such a small role. So I feel like there we probably find out she was actually like Madame Hydra. So when she pops up, we're like, oh shit, it's Madame Hydra. But now we're like, oh shit, it's Val, who could be Madame Hydra. And then we find out, but that's a whole other thing.
That's a whole other story.
But at least it's finally coming out. We'll be able to check it out and go from there. But like I was saying, until next time, stay safe, be well. Adios.
Goodbye.